Hello designers, and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'll show you how to use the corner tool on shapes and curves, set corner type, and I'll also include some tips to help save time when designing complex shapes. Let's jump in. Let's start off by drawing a simple shape. So I'm going to head on over to the tools panel, and I'm going to select the rectangle tool. I'm going to click and drag. I'll keep my finger on shift just to keep it in a square shape and not a rectangle. And you can see here we have a black stroke and a green fill. If you want to change this, and if you're following along with me, you can change it up here in the contextual toolbar. Now this changes based on the tools we've selected. So as you can see, now that we have the rectangle tool selected, we've been given some options. Single radius, absolute sizes, and then corner. And if we hover over corner, it says set corner type. That's what we're going to look at right now. Click on this option. The options we've been given are none, rounded, straight, concave, and cutout. Let's test out rounded. You can see that I now have a little red dot. This is a handle that we can drag in and out to smooth off the sharp corners of our square. If I click and drag, all four corners are being smoothed off, and if I go to the maximum, it's now a circle. I'll leave it halfway. Head on up to the options again. I will choose straight. You can still see we have this handle. And if I just cycle through to show you each of the options, that was the concave and now the cutout. It moves all four corners and that's great. But what if we want to only change one corner and not four? Well, let's go back to it being a square. In the contextual toolbar, you will see single radius. If we uncheck that, it will now give us options to set the top left corner type, top right corner type, bottom left corner type, and bottom right corner type individually. If I hover over this icon, it says set top left corner type. I'll click on that and I will choose the rounded corner. Our handle is back and we can play around with that. Let's set the next one, top right. For this one, I will choose a straight corner. Bottom left, I will choose the concave. And bottom right, I will choose cutout. For each corner of the square we started out with, we were able to change the corner type. And we were able to drag these handles in and out to change the shape slightly. If you look in the contextual toolbar up here, notice how as I drag in and out, the values change. These are the radius values, and as we're working on a vector graphic, it's showing a percentage. Let's try and scale the shape up and down. The structure is kept exactly the same whether it's scaled down or scaled up. If we head on over to the absolute sizes checkbox and click on that, the percentage sign has gone, and it is now in inches. If we scale the shape up and scale the shape down, notice how each corner has remained exactly the same, but just the size of the square is changed by us scaling it down and scaling it up. This is the absolute sizes, and it's in relation to your document. As we're working in inches, I'll just quickly show you how to change those values. Head down to the View tool, the hand button, and here we're able to choose inches, pixels, yards, millimeters, and meters, and so on. My document is in inches, and you can see here 0 to 5, so it's 5 inches across. And if we zoom into our shape, you can see the radius of it is 0.267 right now, and that's in relation to my document and the size of the shape itself. This can be handy if you're working on something that might be printed or might end up on a website. We originally started off with a square, and we used the rectangle tool to make that square. And if you remember, we unchecked the single radius option, and it gave us the option to play around with all four corners of the square. And if you look in the layers panel, it says rounded rectangle, so it knows the shape it started out as. If we want to go in and customize the shape further and add nodes, etc., we would have to go up to the corner tool. And on the corner tool, you'll see we can see nodes. And notice down in the layers panel, it says rounded rectangle. Affinity knows it was a rectangle to begin with. And if we headed back, we could still change these values, like so. But going back to it, if we want to make further changes, notice how this is rounded rectangle, and I will select one of these corners here, and you can see there's an icon with a curved shape. If I click and drag down and let go, you can see in the layers panel, this shape is now a curve. And if we head back to our rectangle tool, you'll see we no longer have the option to change the top left, top right, etc., because this is now a curve. Let's test out scaling up and down to see how that bottom right hand corner performs. And you can see there are changes. If you'd like to scale and it to keep its structure, you can either click convert to curves here and scale down and scale up, and it is node change. Head to the node tool, and you can see it's actually included like nodes here with handles. The alternative way of doing it, if I just step back a bit, the alternative way of doing it is heading to the corner tool and going to bake corners, and that will bake that corner so we can no longer change it. I'll click that, and now you can see I go to the node tool, the nodes are both present. But let's look further into using the corner tool and creating more complex and intricate shapes. The corner tool. Let's draw ourselves a shape. Let's get the rectangle tool and click and drag that. I'll keep my finger on shift to keep it square. And now let's head over to the corner tool and we'll click on that. You can see the contextual toolbar is now showing some different options. We have these grayed out corner tool icons, and I can't really press any of them because I need to select a node or multiple nodes. So if I select the first one in the top left, you can see as I hover over, there's a kind of curved line. If I click and drag on that, it's chosen to smooth off the corner. And now the corner types are highlighted. And if I click on the straight icon, it will make it straight. And so on, we can cycle through those. And we still have our handle down here that we can keep modifying the shape with. If I want to select multiple nodes, I can click and drag. And I've selected the top two, and I will just click on any of those ones, and you can see the changes happening on both of them. I can select multiple nodes where I wouldn't be able to do this. I want to select these two here. I can select the first one, keep my finger on shift. You'll see a little plus icon next to my arrow here. And I will click on that. And now I'll just select one of them, and you can see the corner tool in action. And also you can select all of the nodes and make the changes like so. But what if we want to make a more complex shape? Because we've used all four of these nodes, but we want to add more. So what I do, I would head on over to the node tool, and I would hover near the stroke here. Actually, we can turn this stroke off so you can see the side of the square. So I'd head on over to anywhere along this line, and I'd click once, and you can see I've created a node. So I'm just going to play around with this shape and make some spikes, and then we'll modify that with everything we've learned. I can click and drag if I don't want to create a node, but I want to create a curve there. We'll create a really sharp spike here. And a couple more bits. I've created my new shape, and I want to play around with the corner tool. So I'm going to click on that, and I will just start from the top. And for this one, I can choose the concave. And for this one, let's choose, I'll just use that, and then I will change it afterwards. There we go. So it's a straight edge. If we look closer into this section here, if I want to select multiple like we did before, I click on the first one, keep my finger on shift, and I can select the one over here, and we'll do that, pull it out, and look at that. Let's look at a more complex shape, and I'll show you a tip on how to select various nodes where it might be fairly difficult. Let's grab a star for this one. So let's go over to the tools panel, and there's the star tool. If you don't see it, just click and hold and you'll see more options. I'm going to draw out the star, and I'm going to select 12 points. Now I'll go over to the corner tool and click on that. And like before, I showed you we can select single nodes and click and drag down, or multiple by holding down shift and selecting whichever ones you want. On really complex designs, this can be quite difficult and time consuming. So here's a little trick. Keep your finger on Alt and click and drag. And you can see there's a line now, and I can select. Let me select every other node and we'll see how that turns out. And I'll go around and back, let go. They're all selected. If I just drag down on one, every other node now has this corner tool working on it. And we can do the same for the inside as well. Let's go ahead and do that. Hold down Alt and click and drag, and we'll just do the same again. And I will drag out with this one. I'll go for this one here, which is the cutout. You can make some really interesting shapes. Now I will select one point, hold shift, and just select the remaining, because there aren't that many left. And I will drag that down, and we'll choose something else. We'll choose a flat corner for that one. I have no idea what that is, but we did it all using the corner tool. Just a quick tip here. If we draw our shape, remember that in the layers panel, it will say rectangle. So if you want to add more nodes to it, remember you can't until it's been turned into a curve. And like I've been showing you in the video, you can press on corner tool and then click and drag on one of the corners and it turns into a curve. If I press back, it's still a rectangle now. You can simply click on the node tool here and right click on the square. And then if you go down here, it says convert to curves. And you can see now there's nodes. And if I click on the side, I can start playing around with it. And then I can start playing with the corner tool. All right, that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you liked it, subscribe, give me a thumbs up, maybe leave me a comment. See you on the next one.